a never ending. Where the nights are feeling lonely, there's a place that I can go, where the birds are free to roam. In the sky, flying high over fields of green. And where the stars inside the sky, where the last ones shining bright, pushing through the storm tonight, we'll be burning on and on and on. Where the stars inside the sky, we're the last ones shining bright, pushing through the storm tonight, we'll be burning on and on and on.
Hello Sagittarius. This is Inspire 2016 with your weekly tarot reading for the week, commencing the 12th of December until the 18th of December 2016. The first card for you is representing, how do you feel about yourself? Your card is the Ace of Wands. You are all revved up and raring to go. Use your creative energy and passion to take the first steps and get this project underway. Even if you like to have everything planned out before you begin down a certain path, the Ace of Wands is encouraging you to listen to your instincts and follow your gut. If it feels like a good idea, it probably is. So, start with a few basic actions to get things underway, and then continue to grow and develop your ideas through more complex actions later on. The important thing is that you act now, rather than spending more time planning or researching. The Ace of Wands is also indicative of a time in your life where you have a breakthrough moment and feel very inspired and motivated about a particular idea or passion. Your eyes have been opened to a whole new world and you are now very excited about the possibilities and the opportunities that are available to you. You are showing huge potential at this time and are driven by a strong, creative force. It is as if there is a latent talent within that is just bursting to get out and be fully utilized. This is also a perfect time to draw upon your imagination and to make your dreams reality. You are being offered an opportunity here that shows great promise, but it will be up to you to make the most of it and to maximize the potential for the longer term. It is almost like the spark that is needed to fuel a huge fire, but you must work hard to build the fire up, as the spark itself is not enough to make such a large fire. The energy of the Ace of Wands can also signify restlessness or uncertainty as to how to proceed. You may have energy and passion but not yet have a clear outlet for its expression. All of these wonderful ideas are beginning to build up from within and you are just bursting with energy, but now you must find a way to effectively express this energy in a way that will set you up in the longer term. The second card for you is representing, what do you want most right now? Your card is the Two of Swords. What do you want most right now is clarity of the overall situation. You are currently being faced with a difficult decision, but you are attempting to hide from it and pretending to yourself and others that if you ignore the decision long enough, it will go away of its own accord. However, the decision will not go away simply by your willing it to depart. Your conscience will eventually force you into facing your refusal to deal directly with the situation. The Two of Swords therefore serves as a reminder that life's decisions are frequently quite difficult and raise the possibility of painful consequences. However, you must take the bull by the horns and make your decisions with your best intentions, fully aware of the possible consequences. Avoidance will ultimately lead to a greater conflict. The blindfolded woman in this card is also an indication that you lack the information you need to make the right decisions at this time. You may be missing something, such as threats or potential risks, alternative solutions, or key pieces of information. Once you are able to remove your blindfold and see the situation for what it really is, you will be in a much better position to determine your path forward. research your options more widely, seek outside opinions and feedback, and ask yourself what you are missing here. Why is this decision so challenging to make? What extra information do you need? The Two of Swords often represents a stalemate where there is no winner or loser. You may be at loggerheads with another person and failing to see each other's points of view. What is needed is a truce, where you either agree to disagree or you seek to understand each other's points of view before coming to a final solution. Thus, not only does this card represent potential conflict through a stalemate, it also represents making peace through a truce. Similarly, the Two of Swords can reflect indecision and being at an impasse with regards to an important matter. Again, there is only so much that you can try to put off. At some point or another, you are going to have to make a decision or have a point of view in order to get things moving again. The third card for you is representing your fears. Your card is the Page of Pentacles. You are afraid of manifesting your dreams and goals. There may be current blockages standing in the way of you achieving those goals. It may be that you have not planned sufficiently, or that you have become lazy and complacent and have lost sight of your goal. You may also be too busy daydreaming about new dreams and goals, without having taken any action on your original dreams and goals. So, you need to review your goals and think again about why you were originally motivated to achieve them. Think about what it will be like once you achieve that goal, and become recommitted to your objectives and the actions required to make your dreams a reality. You are focusing on short-term pleasures and desires rather than sustainable and long-term goals. You will need to move beyond material satisfaction and towards what will bring you sustainable happiness and fulfillment. Similarly, you may be finding it difficult to get a specific project or idea off the ground. Each time you try, it seems to amount to nothing, or it takes you even further away from where you want to be. There is a lack of success here and a mounting frustration that perhaps you will never be able to achieve what you want. You may be losing faith in your talents and abilities. If this is the case, relax, lighten up and give yourself some space and downtime for a short period. Take a holiday or a break from your usual routine, and you will find that this helps you to re-energize and refocus. The fourth card for you is representing what is going for you. Your card is the Eight of Swords. You may feel trapped by your own thoughts and perspectives. The woman in this card is blindfolded and bound, trapping her into thinking that she has no way out. However, if only she could remove the blindfold and change her thinking, she would see that she does indeed have options. So, the Eight of Swords suggests that you need to look at a difficult situation from a new angle. Draw upon your intellectual self and your emotional self to determine the best path forward, one that avoids any possible victimization or restriction. The Eight of Swords is often a sign that it is best not to make any important decisions at this point because your thinking has been limited and constrained by self-imposed boundaries. You are struggling to see a situation for what it is and have been led to believe certain things that may or may not be true. There are choices available, but first you must be within the right mindset to know which option to choose. This means releasing the bindings and the blindfold to see the situation from a different, less imposing angle. There may also be too many ideas running through your head. Thus, it is best to wait until you feel more secure and certain about a situation before making important decisions and taking action. If you see part of this woman in yourself, then it is imperative you take back your power and personal accountability and open your eyes to the options that lie in front of you. The fact is that you do have options, even if you do not like those options. This is fine, so long as you accept that you do indeed have options and you do not have to be the victim here. The Eight of Swords portrays a dilemma whereby you are faced with the difficulty of a painful decision and you are at an impasse, uncertain of which way to go. However, what you may not realize is that the decision in the Eight is the result of our own actions. Despite the fact that you have boxed yourself into a corner, there is a way out. The solution is simply to deal with the situation in the most direct yet tactful manner possible, and face your choice with inner strength. It is time to be honest with yourself and others in order to be free of the burden of fear or guilt that is implied with the Eight of Swords. The Eight of Swords can indicate that your interests will be opposed by other people, and this may create restrictions to what it is you want to achieve. Take back your power and realize that you have options whether others oppose you or not. You do not have to be constrained by their way of thinking or their rules. The fifth card for you is representing what is going against you. Your card is the Seven of Pentacles. You are afraid that your efforts may be scattered at this time and you are starting to question whether or not you are investing in the right areas. You may be outlaying some initial money on things that will not actually deliver results. So, the opportunity here is to examine your current and planned investments, both financial and time, and make sure that you are going to see a return on those investments. Use a prioritization system to ensure that you do not waste time and money on areas that will not deliver results. Similarly, the Seven of Pentacles indicates that even though you may continue to invest a lot of energy into a specific situation, you may not reap the rewards you are looking for. As such, this card calls on you to prioritize your activities very carefully. You need to do a cost-benefit analysis on the major tasks involved to bring your project to fruition, as there are certainly a number of tasks that are currently taking a lot of your time and energy but are not bearing the rewards you are seeking. Take stock of what you still need to do and focus only on those things that will get you to where you want to be. You may find that there are a lot of things that you get involved in that are just not value-add. For example, email and meetings are huge time wasters if not used effectively. Try to get down to the 20% of tasks that deliver 80% of the value, and focus on these, rather than investing your time in tasks that do not deliver any results. As a key strength, the Seven of Pentacles can indicate that you know when to stop investing in something when you are seeing little return. Some people are inclined to keep persevering at something, even if it is not working out, just because they have already invested a lot of time, energy or money into it. However, you are very good at identifying when a situation is no longer delivering you any value and knowing when to pack it in and try something else. In a relationship reading, the Seven of Pentacles indicates that you have been working very hard on laying the foundations for your relationship, but now, for some reason, you are concerned that you are going to lose all of that. You may also be feeling frustrated that the relationship is not progressing or growing as quickly as you had hoped, particularly given that you have put in so much time and energy. Sometimes you can pour your heart and soul into something, but it does not always mean that there will be results. You may come to the realization that it just is not worth your time, and no matter how much you try, the relationship is going to continue to hit roadblocks. The last card for you is representing the likely outcome that you may have. Your card is the Three of Pentacles. Ultimately, you will experience prosperity and success in your goals, only if you continue to work toward the fulfillment of your dreams and do not allow disillusionment to dampen your enthusiasm. You need to do work that is satisfying to you and that you can be truly proud of. What new beginnings are you experiencing in the material realm? Is there some project or creative venture you have been putting off because of fear of failure? The Three of Pentacles indicates that dreams can be made real with persistence, determination, and effort. The Three of Pentacles may also suggest that you need help to complete your work and can draw on the knowledge and experience of others. It may be beneficial to share your work with a partner, but only if they are as conscientious as you. At the core of the Three of Pentacles is the notion of teamwork and collaboration. In the card, we see a young mason working hard on building part of the cathedral. The two monks enter, with their worldly knowledge and spiritual understanding, to bring a new perspective to the mason's work. Even though their backgrounds, experience levels and knowledge is very different, they are able to come together to share their expertise in a way that creates synergy and improved results. There is no us and them or any sense of superiority. Rather, each person has something unique to offer and is willing to learn from others involved in the project. Everyone is getting the job done together and is contributing to the group through effective listening and sharing. This is a positive card to see when teamwork, collaboration and cooperation are required between parties with different levels of experience. The Three of Pentacles also points to the importance of feedback. The mason is open to listening to the monks and taking on their feedback on his progress so far. His primary goal is to do a great job, and he knows that the monks will be able to help him get there. He does not take it personally but uses their feedback and input to continually improve in his work. Effective planning, management and organization are also key components of the Three of Pentacles. In order to accomplish significant goals, it is imperative that detailed planning occurs to ensure that all the components are progressing well. This card therefore reflects a time when it is essential to create a detailed plan and to follow a schedule. This is when good project management will pay off. Last but not least, the guidance card for you is the Odin. You are being encouraged to look beyond what your physical eyes are showing you. Look within and follow your intuition or psychic visions. You may want to plan ahead at this time. It's important to keep your mind and energy focused on the best possible outcome. There will be signs and symbols from the light to tell you that you are on the right path. Be aware of winged beings gracing your path as a wink from Odin and the light keepers to say that they are honoring your work.
I hope that you enjoy everything, and if you like the reading, just please click subscribe and you will get instant notifications every time we publish a new video right to your YouTube. Thanks. We'll be right back.